All right, let's see if we can find a bear. That's, problem bear, fuck that.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Weasel, and today we're going to play Firewatch. We got a look at Firewatch with the preview build. We got to see day one and part of day two, but the full game actually does have an intro that we can play through. So we're going to start part three here with the intro and then cut back to where we left off in the last episode. I was thinking about cutting off the intro and releasing it as a separate video if it was a non-interactive one, but here we actually get to make some choices. You see Julia. He's about your age, late 20s, laughing with well-dressed professors and grad students from nearby CU Boulder. You, Henry, are out drinking with your pals. You approach her. You're drunk. You're pretty. That's pretty straightforward. Let's go with that. You're pretty, she says. Coolly. What? You're not. You're a future hangover. What? You reply, confused. Someone should buy you a cheeseburger, she says. He flags down a waiter, and 1 week later, you're Julia's boyfriend. That happens fast. Alright. Oh, this looks like we're in the hospital. Backpack. Alright, let's... Or, no, this might just be an apartment building. I have no idea where I am. Oh, okay. Downstairs. I guess this is where we live. And this seems to be my truck. Get in. You date for over a year. She drives you absolutely nuts. It's great. You move in, you share an apartment near the school with a view of the mountains. You two drink beers out on the deck. You drink beer just about anywhere. Life is good. Julia wants to get a dog. Aw. Let's get a dog, shall we? There's a scruffy, undersized beagle. Julia's in love. She wants to bring it with her to class. There's also an intimidating but gentle-eyed German shepherd. Nothing bad could happen to Julia while walking this dog. It's badass. Oh, man. What about Shepherd? Name him Mayhem. Beagle. Let's get her the Beagle. Name him Bucket. Bucket's a good dog, and a week later, you've totally forgotten about the other one. Julia loves him. You love him, too. 1979. You talk out on the deck. It's summer, 9:30 p.m., and the heat still radiates off the high desert. What do you think about kids, she asks. Kids, they're not very smart, or good at much. I'm saying if you and I have some, a couple little idiots. That would be pretty good. One day, why rush? That would be pretty good. In that case, we should probably get married. Yeah, I would like that, you say. These kids are going to be screwed up enough. It's probably for the best that their parents are hitched. You say she's absolutely right. And I think this is now a little bit later, pretty much at the start of the park, I'm gonna say. Do not forget to check in. I hope we did that. No fireworks. You're in their country. Learn to live with bears. Thoroughfare trail is not recommended for inexperienced hikers. Well, let's get to our summer job. What a beautiful, calm start. It's a Thursday night and Julia is, 4 hours late. She doesn't call. You're worried and getting angrier by the minute. She walks in after you've gone to bed. She's not quite drunk, but she's clearly been having a fun time. You fight when she gets between the sheets. Ow. Let's tell her our problems. Let's not sulk. You call an inconsiderate asshole. Jeez. She tells you to fuck yourself and to not be such a baby. You call her selfish. She knows you mean it and it hurts her feelings. Julia still likes to draw. She draws plants from her research. She draws all the places you go. She draws you. You pose and flex like He-Man. You look awesome. Alright. Seems to be a little bit later. I think this skips back and forward between the past and now. Two forks, fire lookout, 8 more miles still. Alright, we got a little bit ahead. 1982. During the summers, you and Julia enjoy walking Bucket at night. There's a festival in town. It brings in folks from faraway places. One of them tries to mug you with a knife. How dare does... Bucket gets kicked. Oh. Beep, beep, bah, fuck, the dog, Julia yells. She gets flustered and has trouble speaking when she's stressed. You confront the attacker. You beat his goddamn face in. Yeah, you better. Kicking the friggin' dog. Your arm gets cut up, but you beat the guy to a pulp. You don't feel very tough. You cry your eyes out before the cops show up. Julia asks to take a different path from that day forward. You say okay, you don't want to go that way either. Okay. From then on, you walk by the river. 1984. Plans to have kids get waylaid by work. Julia gets offered a job at Yale. Yale is in Connecticut, 2,000 miles away. It's a great job. Associate department chair. She wants to move. You absolutely do not. You convince her to not take the job or agree if she commutes back and forth. Jeez. 2,000 miles away. Why is me not going not an option? I'll agree if she commutes back and forth. You'll ask her if she'll commute back and forth. You don't want to move to Connecticut. She says that it will be hard, but she'll do it if you don't want to move. You tell her not to pass it up if what's she wants. She agrees. She flies back to Boulder 3 times each semester. 1985. Julia is sent home from Yale on paid leave after having an episode. She lost it on a colleague for borrowing books that were important to her research. She didn't remember she had happily loaned them to him just 2 days prior. Ooh, jeez. She was found crying in the stairwell. You say that maybe you guys should talk to someone about it. That's probably a good idea. After seeing multiple doctors and having many tests, they are worried that Julia might be suffering from early onset dementia. She's 41. You both decide to keep it a secret for now. Alright. I think I'm camping outside on my way to the outpost. Now look at the beautiful sky. Well, let's pick up the journal, let's see. Did we write anything? Oh, wait, it's hers! Let's see, and only a few... Wait. Oh. I don't want to read it. Bucket is getting older. Julia comments that it's kind of nice because he gets in less trouble around the house. A week later, she goes back to the university. 1987. Julia's affliction gets worse. She can't remember things in her class. Her research is in shambles. She drives a car to the next town over for no particular reason and has to be brought home by the police. She's devastated. She's sent home on permanent medical leave. Some days you get the Julia who calls you a dope and your unborn children little idiots. Other days you get a stranger. She pulls you into bed to make love. After 5 minutes, she goes into a panic, believing her dad is at the door. You tell her family. They're crushed and begin to make trips to and from their home in Australia to visit her. For a while, your friends come by with little things to brighten the day. She gets worse. 1988. You spend your days following Julia around the house. You count the seconds between the 2 weekly visits from Daniel, the nurse. He suggests that you could live somewhere else, somewhere with 24-hour care, a home. It sits with you for a couple of months. You're determined to take care of her by yourself. And I guess we're making some progress getting to the Firewatch outpost. I like how the colors drastically change just between daytime and late at night. It's really beautiful. Hey there, buddy. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid. I mean, he's obviously gonna run. Smart deer. It is impossibly hard. The worst is when you get mad at her, like when she tries to cook her own food. You can't do anything without her, and she can't do anything without you. When she goes to sleep, you stay up for a few hours, drinking on the deck, watching baseball in the summer, college basketball in the winter. Drinking then too. You start going out after you put her to bed. The first time you do it, you worry about her getting up and walking around while you're gone. Jeez, you put a chair in front of the bedroom door. You trust that she sleeps like a rock. Let's go with that. Let's not imprison her. Still a shitty thing. You go to the same bar at the boring end of Pearl Saint. It's nice there. Over time, you tell Sheila, the bartender, everything. It's a huge weight off. You're home and in bed by 1 a.m. a couple nights a week. You look forward to those nights. Somewhat understandable, I guess. One night, you're stopped at a DUI checkpoint. You blow it 0.10, and you're taken to jail for the night. You consider trying to hide it, but you tell your sister-in-law, Susan. Julia's parents take the next plane from Australia. They can't believe the state your house is in. Then they tell you Julia's coming to live with them. You don't argue, you sail your visit soon. A few weeks go by. Summer's coming, and you see an ad in the paper for a job. You take it. And I'm pretty sure that is, yes, where we're catching up to the start of Firewatch, the lookout tower. Alright, so this is where I'm gonna cut it to where we left off in part 2. And if you guys wanna follow along and haven't watched Firewatch yet, the preview build, you can watch episode 1 and episode 2. They're linked in the description below. And yeah, we're gonna continue where we left off in part 2. Alright, so now we're here. I backtracked through the game up until this point and pretty much did everything the same that I did in the previous 2 episodes. Just so there's no variation in any outcome of the game. We're gonna look through the campfire, their little camp, and let me give you a quick recap of what happened in case you decided to not watch episode 1 and 2, which I highly recommend though. Basically, I'm Henry, and from the intro you might have gathered, I have a wife that had dementia and now lives with her family because I couldn't take care of her anymore, and I'm kinda like escaping into the woods as a Firewatch, just like a summer job. And yeah, we screwed with the teens by throwing their radio into the water after they set off fireworks in in a forest and also made campfires, which is very dangerous, and that's what we have here as well, a campfire. We've been looking for them, and supposedly they cut through the wire, the communication wire, so yeah, they're also possibly responsible for that, and we met a strange figure. We don't know who that is, but yeah, that is pretty much all I know. And yeah, me and Delilah are having some fun conversations over the radio. Anyway, let's dump that fire out first and report that.
I see a campsite and it looks like they've got a fire.
Yeah, of course they do.
That seems like it. I swear, they must have dragged 4 cases of beer out here.
That is impressive.
And don't let them see you.
What a job this is.
Yeah, I guess I'm not taking that. The only thing that I did different from the last time we played in episode 1 and 2 is that I picked up all the trash I could find, so all the cans, I actually cleaned them up. Oh, my sheets!
I found my sheets!
So they did break into your tower.
Looks like it.
Looks like.
Well, those are my sheets, definitely. Why wouldn't... Can I take them? I guess I don't want them anymore. Yeah, that's clear evidence. But then there's this. This ripped apart tent. Alright, here's the note. I'm gonna read through it real quick again. Hope you're fucking happy. We're leaving, we're going to find the police or whatever and tell them about how you creeped us out on the lake and then came and destroyed our campsite and all of our stuff and stealing panties is gross out. You're probably a mental fucking and ex-murderer and are so going to jail. I hope it was worth being a jerk over some fireworks, dick. I wonder if they wrote it or someone else might have. It seems weird. I'm gonna hold on to that though.
Oh, they're gone for sure.
How can you tell?
Well, the girls left someone, me, I guess, a note.
Well, what's it say?
Calling the police, think they attacked them.
I need to call the police because they think I attacked them.
Oh my god, well,
nope.
Did you?
I mean, just destroyed the radio.
I didn't do this, okay? Someone or something went to town here, but it wasn't me.
Because I told you to scare them, not assault them.
I didn't. Of course I didn't. I just threw their stereo in the lake.
Yeah, I really wish you wouldn't have done that.
Well,
this is, I don't know, weird as hell, but it wasn't me.
It's okay. I believe you. Weird stuff happens in the woods. It could be other campers. They could be having a bad mushroom trip. We really don't know, but they're gone. There's no way to call the cops. They're not coming back, and we can get to work. I'd really like to start enjoying a quiet summer.
Oh yeah, me too. And exactly this is where it cut off. This is day 3. I thought I could report maybe something else. But yeah, we're gonna continue with day 3. Ah, look at me fixing the window. Find boards downstairs to patch up window. I got you covered. I always walk the wrong way. Yes.
Hey, Henry?
Yeah.
What do you look like?
Why are you asking?
Because I'm horribly superficial.
Well, like
Burt Reynolds.
Well, I get confused for Burt Reynolds all the time.
Oh, is that so?
Mm-hmm.
Women say that we have a similar musk.
Uh-huh.
Hey, you asked.
Okay, well, that gives me a good start. Now let's see. In my scope, I can only tell you're a white guy wearing shorts.
You need a better scope,
it's
then.
Hot. And maybe, by the way, I'm not white. It's not very, you know, PC or whatever they say.
Oh my god, you are the whitest man. Wow. I don't need a spotting scope for that. And if not shorts, then what do you normally like to wear?
What do I normally like to wear? Clothes. I don't really think about it. Tuxedos as often as possible. Yeah, I wear tuxedos.
Tuxedos as often as possible.
Oh, really?
Totally.
You bet.
How cosmopolitan. I didn't realize Boulder was so chic.
It is the peak of high society.
I really enjoy their back and forth.
Now tell me about your face. I'm looking at you across the bar. What do I see?
I could go over there, I guess. I have a thick beard. My nose has been broken. I could mention that. That happened.
I got a broken nose. It's not bad or anything, but yeah.
How'd you do that? Your illustrious boxing career?
I wish.
I need more boards.
Jumped on my back and I slipped and ate a parking meter.
Ouch. That sounds like it hurts.
I want to know about your eyes.
Oh la la.
Get out of here.
I'm drawing you. I need to know.
Oh.
You're what?
Interesting.
Is that okay?
Don't
answer. I'm going to do it regardless.
Fine.
Your eyes. Tell
me. There's another one. Very good. My eyes. It's tired.
They look tired, I think.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, you know, you hit a certain age and you think you're a younger person who just looks tired all the time.
Speak for yourself, mister.
But I guess that's getting old.
Well, some people might see distinguished.
Oh, I gotta remember that word. I like
okay,
that.
Okay, got it. Thank you, Henry.
You get what you need?
Absolutely.
I do really enjoy the fact that you get to do a task while you talk to Delilah. Where's the towel, by the way? Over there. I should say hi. Oh, I can't. Oh, bummer. Oh, hey Wheatley, you're coming to say hi? How's it going? He usually hides behind my neck, so he's always there, but every once in a while he peeks by to see what's up. I think I need another board. Ah, there it is. Wonderful. Gimme. Thank you. So yeah, the reason my window is broken and vandalized, in case you didn't watch part one and part two, is because, I mean, I assume that the girls came and ruined my place. I mean, they stole the sheets. We found them at the campsite. So, But it's still weird that they would tear off their clothes.
So, what should I do now? What's next?
What's next? What do you think is next?
Well, you've been the one giving me tasks for 2 days straight.
What's next is you sit in that room until September 1st and call me at the first sign of smoke.
Oh, yeah.
Why don't you let me know when you're mentally prepared for that task and I'll give it to you.
Well, I think I'm mentally prepared for that. I think I can do that. Just sit around and watch. All right, I'm ready.
Okay, I think I am ready to tackle my long-term commitment of keeping this national forest safe from total destruction.
Oh, hey!
I'm glad to hear you've Chert really
Reynolds.
Thought this through.
Of course.
Of course.
We've issued you a comfy chair to sit in and everything.
Ooh,
you know,
comfy
it's not
chairs.
Really that comfy. It's wooden and there's no padding. I think I actually got a splinter in my thigh this morning.
Aww. Well, regardless, take a seat. The forest depends on you.
All right. Oh, day 9. We skipped a few. Like, 5 or 6. Ooh. Tasty. Tasty
Hello,
sandwich.
Henry. Having a nice afternoon?
Oh, yeah. I'm having a nice afternoon. Would you look at that? That is pretty. Yeah. I might never leave.
Well, I called with some bad news.
What is it?
2 young women, Chelsea Stevens and Lily McLean, were reported missing. They've got parents out in California who haven't heard from them in a week.
That's not good.
They were supposed to meet an aunt down in Cody. If they're the girls from last week, then you're probably the last person to have seen them.
Well, and naked and angry. I'm happy to be questioned. Well, I didn't do anything.
I didn't do anything to them.
Except destroyed their stuff.
Well, yeah,
just
that's
stereo.
A thing.
Don't get defensive. Look, it's not going to be an issue. I mean, if they turn up dead, then maybe. Should I just not say anything and save us the trouble?
Yeah, it's worth mentioning.
I think it's worth mentioning something.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'll keep it vague. I really don't want to talk to the cops.
Me neither.
All right, Henry, thanks. Enjoy the sunset.
I will try my best. Well, another few days have passed. It's probably going to be a while that we're here. So that's 6 days after that.
Henry. Henry, wake up.
Oh, middle of the night. I hope everything's okay. Let's hope there's not a fire.
Get out of bed and pick up the radio.
Gotcha. What's up?
What do you want?
Hey, you big dumb idiot.
Wait. She sounds drunk. Hi, Julia. Oh, Julia, not Delilah. Why did I say Delilah? Wait. Oh, Julia is my wife. I'm just confused. Babe, it's late.
It's late.
I know it is.
Wait.
You sound tired.
Oh.
I
think I'm dreaming.
Are you having a nice time?
Oh, it's good here.
Yeah, it's good here. It's beautiful, you know?
That's great, Henry. Really great. Well, I'll let you get back to sleep then.
That is...
Okay, Jules.
Delilah seems nice.
Yeah, she does.
Mm-hmm.
Sure. This is a weird dream.
Bye, baby.
Yep, that... Maybe I'm going crazy. It's quite possible. Day 33. It's been over a month at this point. What are we looking at?
Is it too much of a pain in the ass to bring supplies all the way up to our towers?
Well,
I guess it is.
Delivered.
All right,
well,
we're picking up supplies.
Work?
It's the perks of a decade of service.
Mm.
You're out hiking in 90 degree heat and... I get to do crosswords. Isn't life miserably unfair?
It is.
Anyway, when you find the supply drop, remember it's not just for you, okay? Other lookouts, biologists, a few people get their food there, and I don't want to have to call in for more.
Alright.
Loads of good stuff, though. Beans, prunes, jerky.
Nice, I like jerky.
You know, my sister eats 6 prunes a day. 6. She's, like, really precise about it. She'd be great at this job if she didn't need wheelbarrows full of marijuana to function.
Alright, we're gonna have to hike north, which is actually not too far from Delilah's supply drop, isn't it?
2 weeks ago, you called me in the middle of the night.
Oh.
You were sleeping, I guess, and all I heard was the name Jules through the mumbles.
Well, that's awkward now.
I thought it was so sweet. I wanted to wake you up, but then I thought maybe you were having a nice conversation and... I'd just be spoiling it. I hope you're doing okay, you know, when it comes to her.
I shouldn't be here. I mean, I guess, I don't know.
I am.
Oh, well, okay.
I'm glad.
I guess I'm okay. I didn't mean to select that, but...
So, a couple of months before I took this job, I...
Wait, where do we go?
I was with this guy, Javier.
Javier.
He's incredible, caring, sexy as hell. He was a driller down in Casper. We dated for almost 5 years. I was working with the Wyoming Outdoor Leadership School, and I was obsessed with it. I wanted to be an instructor so badly. And I was sure I was going to marry Javier as soon as I could be bothered. Walls was also a good excuse to get out of town, drink whiskey in the mountains, cut loose. Then, Javier's brother got killed working in Gillette, and for some reason, I didn't come home.
Huh.
Javier said it was fine, he'd go to the funeral, take care of his mom, stuff like that, it'd be easier solo. When he came back, he left me. I came out here, I lied and told my sister he fucked our neighbor.
Well, that's easy, so, I guess.
I lied to you. I came out here with a broken heart just like you.
Well, I don't know if I got a broken heart.
You've told me so much about you, so, you know, there's something about me. We both fucked up.
Well, thank you for being so honest. I guess I don't have to say anything to that. Yeah, we're heading to the supply drop, getting some good food. Apparently nothing else came of the girls so far after, like, several weeks. We didn't find anything. Okay, supply drop. Good. Good. Thanks for the signs. That really helps. Wait. Oh, a cache. Fantastic. That is a supply cache. Cool. So, what's the code?
Found the supplies.
Oh, good. Enjoy.
Well, I guess it's 1234 again. Kind of feel they should use a better number for this one. That's the first one that I would try. Ah, all right. Two forks. Pick up. That's mine. Spruce and Moss Peak. I'll take that. Thank you. All right, let's head home.
All right, I got everything I need out of here. Time to chow down.
Just yours, right?
Yes.
Who do you think I am?
Yeah, day 64, jeez. This really speeds ahead. Next time it's gonna be day 800-something. Oh, fire.
You've got a front row seat for what might be the biggest fire of the year.
Wow.
Yeah, it's really going.
I'm gonna call it in. They'll send in a hotshot crew for some suppression, but I bet we'll be stuck with her for the rest of the summer.
Wow, and rest of the summer?
She doesn't have a name yet. I usually think of something funny or something practical or a little risque when coming up with them. But why don't you do the honors?
How about Delilah?
Delilah's a nice name.
You charmer.
No, you big dummy.
I was kidding.
No, you were not. You're sweet, but we can't call it the Delilah Fire.
Why?
Okay, what then?
How about my middle name, June?
The June Fire, even though it's July.
Seems fine.
I like it. So there's this creek down the hill, and, you know what my favorite thing to do is?
I like how calm they are about the fire. Just, it's fire.
What's that?
I love to take a bottle of whatever I have on hand, plunge it deep into the water, and let it chill in there all day. And then, on nights like tonight, when it is so disgustingly hot, I have something nice and cool to drink. I learned that from my sister in Santa Fe. She'd do that with a bottle of tequila near her house and make margaritas the size of your head. You'd like it there.
Oh, I bet. I've had a bad time with tequila. I would if I was with you. Ooh, okay, maybe not so forward.
I've had one too many bad experiences with tequila. A little reticent to try it again.
Well, maybe you just need a new, good experience with it.
Oh.
Yeah, maybe.
Are you looking at the fire?
No, I'm not.
Well, now I am.
You should. Let me know when you are.
All right.
Okay, I'm looking at it again.
I love how they look at night. During the day, it's just smoke, but when the sun is down, you can just get lost.
Yeah.
Hashtag deep.
I'm glad you're here.
Oh, thank you. Why do you say that?
Why do you say that?
Because I do. I'm not crazy. I mean, we've had such a good time, right?
Yeah, we did.
Yeah, I think so.
I don't talk to the other lookouts as much as I talk to you. Not in the same way. And I know you're not really available, but I want you to know, well, maybe it'd be nice to get together at the end of the summer.
Really not comfortable with that.
Or even talk about it. I'm just having the thought. I wish I was over there.
You know what? She seems nice.
I wish you were too.
Jeez.
We could sit outside. We could talk about these radios. We could, you know.
I should drink. Oh, I should reply. What could we do?
What could we do?
Well, let me tell you.
All right, 10 days later, I think last day was 66.
You're going fishing without a license?
It's one fish, and I'm sick of all the stuff I got to eat.
Well, I won't tell anyone you're a poacher.
Thank you very much.
Reminds me, I keep hearing reports from Fish and Game about a problem bear they're trying to keep tabs on. Can you search around the lake for fresh tracks and just let me know what you find? There was a crew burning fire lines out to the east, and, you know, I think sometimes it riles up the wildlife.
Alright, let's see if we can find a bear. That's, problem bear, fuck that. Huh.
Problem bear, fuck that. I am of the opinion that they are all problems.
Wow.
Come on, please.
Well, they would eat me, I'm pretty sure.
Ugh. Can't believe I'm gonna leave this planet as a pile of bear shit.
Thank you, Henry.
Yeah.
All right. Well, apparently there's some romance happening between Delilah and Henry, and I mean, I can't completely blame him, but it is a little bit awkward. Put away. I can put it away for now. I don't need to hold that in my hand. All right. We're at the lake. Let's see if we can find some bear tracks. Oh, what's that? Oh, notes. Clipboard. Pick up. What we got here? Interesting. Let's see what we have.
I found a clipboard down here, and there's something strange going on.
At the lake? What's up?
Someone has written down what we said to each other, have been saying.
Okay.
That doesn't make any sense.
I don't talk to the other lookouts as much as I talk to you, not in the same way.
No way.
Okay. What?
Wait, hold on. Something's out here.
Locate strange noises
Henry.
Towards the canyon.
I'm worried.
Yeah, that is a weird note, I gotta say. Oh, jeez.
Find and eat any mushrooms?
No!
I mean, they can be fun, but also, you know, devastating.
Let's keep that thing, just to be sure.
Regardless, just let me know, okay, Buckaroo?
Alright, we got a radio.
I don't know why I just called you that.
What's up? Oh, Jesus! Yep. Oh, we got knocked out. Straight knocked out.
Henry, are you there?
Well, I'm there again.
What happened, Henry?
I got hit in the head, punched or something by someone.
That really.
Are you serious? What the hell is going on out there?
I don't know. Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
Let me get this straight. You found a clipboard with what? Transcripts of our conversations? What else is on it?
I don't know. It's gone, along with a radio of theirs. Somebody out here could have just killed me, Delilah.
Jesus.
I don't... What the fuck is going on?
I would like to know.
I don't know.
I saw the name Wapiti Station right before I was cold-cocked. Does Wapiti Station mean anything to you?
Wapiti Meadow. Maybe it's Wapiti Meadow. It's on our maps. It's not too far from where you are right now.
All right.
It's where you saw that damn fence. It's north of the lake. It looks like there should be a trail somewhere on the north shore of Jonesy Lake.
All right, I guess we're going to go there.
I'll start hiking that way now. God damn it, my head.
Are you sure you saw what...
Pretty sure, yeah.
Maybe you pissed off some more campers and they came back to sucker punch you.
Well, I got sucker punched, all right. Why would I make this up?
This just seems like a misunderstanding or something.
No.
Why would I make this up? It's an insane lie at worst, and a shitty prank at best.
Yep.
And you've been feeling okay?
I feel fine.
Yeah, I haven't gone crazy, I think.
Okay, I'm sorry. I believe you, but that conversation was from 2 weeks ago.
I know they were. So what's to say that they don't have transcripts from 3, 4, or 5 weeks ago?
That's really weird.
Friendship, our whole summer.
That's really
Someone
awkward.
Is out here with the walkie-talkie, taking notes and talking to God knows who.
And he's probably listening right now. What is going on behind that fence? We should leave. I'll get to the bottom of this.
I'll get to the bottom of this.
Great. But just keep a clear head. Don't, you know, do anything crazy.
Like taking a job in the middle of nowhere with literally no escape from whatever or whoever is out there?
Well, I meant, like, kill anybody.
I'll try. All right, wow, that really took an intense turn. I'm really looking forward to this. I'm going to cut it here. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed this episode, make sure to leave a like, and I hope to see you guys in the next one where we hopefully get some answers. Oh, yeah, there's a chain link fence. Anyways, thanks for watching. I'm Weasel. I'm out, and hope to see you around. Bye-bye. Bow.
Bam, 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 bam.